So I actually now would like to call up another woman who is amazing and fantastic and brilliant, and I think slipped off somewhere. Monifa Pandeli? Huh? She had to leave? Oh, okay. So who's gonna be? Okay. No, I mean, not that I'm disappointed. I just, there was a change and I wasn't prepared. You know, like Kevin Hart, she wasn't ready. Beatrice is a very good, no, stop doing that. You're gonna come introduce your coworker and colleague. She's so brilliant, this woman, but is like, I think, a major introvert. We have the Moms Rising team here who today sponsored this amazing spread that you are about to have. Prepared by Boscombe Catering and sponsored by Moms Rising. And part of that is we were thinking about radical and fierce women, warriors out here doing the work. Moms Rising has been right on the front line, particularly Monique and her team here in New York. Last year I was on their panel for Food Power 2013. It was amazing, took place at the Marriott in Brooklyn. We talked about sort of this coercive corporate marketing, junk food marketing to our children. We honored and highlighted how we can use social media and blogging and health and wellness. They have all of these volunteers and bloggers who are reporting on all of the different issues that are affecting our children and are really increasing the childhood obesity epidemic. And so today, you know, through the celebration of food, they are honoring women who have been doing this work right on the front lines. They're gonna have a panel about how to use social media and blogging in health and wellness. And they got their step and repeat set up out there. They're giving away lots of swag. Make sure you don't leave without any. And so I'm gonna allow their staff to come up and talk a bit more about what Moms Rising is doing, how you can stay engaged if you've been engaged with them, how you can engage if this is the first time you're hearing about them, and what the next 90 minutes has in store for you. So, Moms Rising.
Some work in the schools where we were able to advocate to make sure that healthy school meals were available to our children. And this is huge. It's huge because our children spend most of their day inside schools. And in low-income families, they also receive their breakfast and their lunch. They stay there until sometimes 5, 6 o'clock in the afternoon with their after school, and they need to receive that food that will fuel them. That food is power. And so we're so excited because these women that we're honoring today help us get to that point. And so we want to start it off. And Beatrice is going to hand out some awards, and then I'll hand out some awards to some very, very special bloggers who were on the grounds with us. They were doing deliveries, they were writing about it, they were spreading the word, and we want to make sure that they're honored because they are our good food force, and that's what we call them. They're our good food force against everything out there, and they have made this possible.
It's especially bittersweet to be here because for the past 5 years I've spent a lot of time on the ground organizing parents throughout the city around school food and wellness. And oftentimes those parents go unrecognized for the tremendous victories that they make each and every day in the lives of our children. And not just for their own kids, but the hundreds and thousands and almost, well, over a million kids that attended New York City public schools. So it's amazing to be like here with Moms Rising and leverage the national power that they have to honor these amazing moms and parents that do this work on the ground. So with that said, the first person I'd like to call up is Shenora Heath. Mother of three beautiful children, 19, 15, and 10, two of them who are here today. Why don't you come and join your mom up here, because she does this for you. Shenora is no stranger to the importance of volunteering and parent participation in schools. In 2010, with no prior knowledge of gardening, Ms. Heath embarked on a journey with other parents and students with the goal of building a garden at her children's school in the Ocean Hill Brownsville neighborhood. Ms. Heath knew early on that building the garden would support hands-on learning, boost student morale, and increase the exposure of students and parents in Brownsville to green spaces and opportunities for environmental stewardship. What started as a flower garden around the middle school quickly grew to become a full-on vegetable garden. With help from students, administrators, outside community organizations, the garden is now thriving. The school now runs a farmer's market open to the community with surplus produce donated to a local food pantry in Brownsville, Brooklyn. Ms. Heath is now a parent fellow with the Brooklyn Food Coalition. She joined the coalition in 2010 and became part of the first cadre of parent fellows in 2011. While training, Ms. Heath received, she was able to organize other parents around school food issues. Their first major victory at her school was eliminating chocolate milk from the breakfast menu at their school. She now uses what she learns to support other parent trainings at other schools. Her goal is to educate parents on school food, about the importance of volunteering at their children's school, and making sure that they know that their voices make a difference in the lives of their own children and in the lives of others. Brownsville, Brooklyn. Her tireless dedication to the students and broader community has opened doors for beautiful partnerships with organizations in the community. She is respected among her peers and continues to nurture and grow the youth and parents she meets each and every day. So we will hold that award. To call up is Bess Hauser. Bess has spent the last 5 years actively engaged in her Brooklyn community. From the Gowanus Canal Conservancy, the Brooklyn Food Coalition, Brad Lander's participatory budgeting process, to an extensive involvement in parent leadership at PS32 in Gowanus. Bess has worked tirelessly to create spaces for diverse parent leadership so no parent's voice is left out. When her daughter arrived at PS32, chocolate milk was served at every meal, and there was no fresh water source in the cafeteria. To change this, she founded the Nutrition Committee with other parents, which has not only accomplished its initial goals, but added a salad bar, added fresh water sources, and water sources in portable classrooms throughout the school. She's formed partnerships with the Brooklyn Food Coalition, Food Fight, and has improved standards for food at school events as well. Thanks to the work of a number of parents in this capacity, PS32 has received the Excellence in School Wellness Award from the DOE. And as an extension of the Nutrition Committee, Bess helped create and oversee a garden at PS32, which won the citywide Golden Apple Award from the Department of Sanitation this year. Okay, so there's one more that we want to also honor, who's also not here. It's Ola Ronk. Love warrior. She reveres children, trees, change, imagination. Her work centers around health, healing, love, and spiritual liberation. She has led a variety of workshops all over the world, birthed out of the goodness of life, compassion, and social responsibility. She has worked as a food science and health educator, creating and implementing award-winning curriculum that introduces children and teens to the concepts of agriculture, sustainability, food marketing, healthy eating, and nutrition through the use of gardening and growing food. She currently serves on the board of the Brooklyn Queens Land Trust, a nonprofit organization built around preserving gardens and green spaces throughout Brooklyn and Queens. She leads the annual Brooklyn Queens Land Trust Bike Tour, which takes over 100 local residents of Brooklyn through the borough, visiting a variety of neighborhood gardens and green spaces. So before we do the Blogger Awards, let's just give some love.